अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम साजिद अली। इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस ब्रिटिश कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रिफॉर्म्स इन इंडिया। सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, ब्रिटिश व्हेन दे केम टू इंडिया, दे ऑक्यूपाइड सम रीजन्स एंड दे स्टार्टेड रूलिंग देम। आफ्टर द वॉर ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस दे डायरेक्टली ब्रिटिश डायरेक्टली रूल्ड ओवर इंडिया। सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, ब्रिटिश at first introduced reform in 1861. The reforms, its name Indian Councils Act 1861. So dear friends, I discussed with you about 1861 constitutional reforms in my previous lecture. So its name legislative control of British over India. So in this lecture we discuss Indian Councils Act 1892 and Minto Morley reforms 1909. Dear friends, slowly and gradually, time by time, British government in India realized the need for reforms, constitutional reforms, because of the changing of conditions in India. That's why they introduced different reforms at different times. Indian Councils Act, it was also a constitutional reforms after Indian Councils Act 1861. So dear friends, according to Indian Councils Act 1892, additional members in Executive Council were increased from 10 to 16. In last constitutional reforms, the additional members were from 6 to 12. So they were increased. And dear friends, additional members was also called non-official members. Non-official members, those people who were natives, who were Indians, they were not English people. And it was the first step, first constitutional reforms in the history of British period, when Indians were nominated for Executive Council, Governor Generals. So dear friends, in 1892, their number was raised, increased from 10 to 16. So dear friends, these are Indian members, major leaders: G.K. Gokhale, Sir S.P. Mehta, Ashutosh Mukherjee, Rush Bihari Ghosh, Nawab Salimullah Khan. They were major leaders. That's why we write their names. And dear friends, additional members in provincial councils, along with in executive councils, Indians were also in provincial councils under the governor. In executive council, they were under governor general. In provincial councils, they were under governors. So dear friends, in 1892 reforms, in additional councils, provincial level, their numbers were 8. Its number was fixed 8 members, additional members for a province under the Executive Council of Governor in provinces. But in Bengal, their numbers were 20. In this way, we discuss constitutional reforms, Indian Councils Act 1892. So, dear friends, in this act, additional members, non-official members, had limited powers. But in 1861, Indian Councils Act, they had no any power. They just could sit in council. They just see the activities of British government. They had no powers in 1861 councils, but in this act they had given a power, limited power. They just could ask questions, just a single question, not supplementary extra questions. So, dear friends, now we discuss Minto Morley reforms 1909. When time passed, so British government also realized some changing in constitution, so they started constitutional development. So, dear friends, additional members in Executive Council in 1909 were 60. Their number was fixed, 60. Out of 60 members, 23 members were non-official. But remaining members were official. 23 non-official members were Indians. They were natives. So, dear friends, S.P. Sinha was the first Indian who was executive member, member of Executive Council. After the resignation of S.P. Sinha, Syed Ali Imam became the member of Executive Council. So, dear friends, additional members in provincial councils, their number was also fixed in Bengal, Bombay, Madras. Their number 50. But in Punjab and Burma, their number 30. Along with these members, there were other 4 members. They were under Executive Council of Governor. So, dear friends, this is a provincial council under the Executive Council of Governor. So, the 4 members in Executive Council, and these members were under the Governor and its Executive Council. In this reforms, they had given some extra powers. They could ask questions, supplementary extra questions, and they also could present a resolution for the problems of Indian people. They could also discuss yearly budget, financial budget. So, dear friends, separate electorate in this reforms, Minto Morley reforms, separate electorate was given only Muslims. because as I discussed with you in a lecture, when Shimla deputation, we discussed in Shimla deputations, Muslim leaders went to Lord Minto, Viceroy of British in India. They said him about the separate electorate for Muslims. In this way, in 1909 reforms, British government accepted the demands of separate electorate for Muslims. So now Muslims could elect their representatives, just only Muslims. After Minto Morley reforms, the representatives of Muslims were only Muslims. Indirect electoral system. According to Minto Morley reforms 1909, election system was also introduced in India subcontinent. At first, public, they elect local bodies, and local bodies elect provincial legislature, and provincial legislatures elect imperial legislature. This is under Governor General, and provincial legislatures were under governors, and local bodies who were the representatives of public, they were natives especially. So dear friends, in this way we discuss British constitutional reforms in India, and they brought reforms, changes and development in their constitutions politically at different times. At first 1861, second 1892, and third 1909. So inshallah we will discuss in my next lecture Lucknow Pact and other topics. Thank you very much, dear friends. Take care. Allah Hafiz.